Hello students, in the previous class we discussed the concept related to normals of an ellipse. What is the equation of normal at x1 comma y1 to the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1 a square x by x1 minus b square y by y1 is equals to a square minus b square. Normal at p of theta becomes what? Ax by cos theta minus by sin theta is equals to a square minus b square. This is the equation of normal at p of theta to the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. From that equation, we can prove that the condition that the line lx plus my plus n equal to 0 is normal to the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1 is a square by l square plus b square by m square is equals to a square minus b square whole square by n square. Now we continue the class. Now let us discuss the properties of normals to the ellipse and then we do some of the problems related to the normals. Okay, let us begin the class. Properties of normals to the ellipse. Let us see. This is the property. At most four normals can be drawn from given point to the ellipse. Let P be any point in the plane of your ellipse. At most four normals can be drawn through that point to the ellipse. That means at the point of intersection of the line and the curve, the tangent is perpendicular to that line. So at that time we say that is normal to the ellipse. Such type of normals are only four. At most four normals can be drawn from the given point to the ellipse. That is the property. How to derive this one? Now, this is an ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to 1. This is any point P in the plane of ellipse. We have to prove that at most four normals can be drawn through this point to the ellipse. Okay, this is one normal, this is another one, this is third one, this is fourth one. That means if you draw tangents at these points, the angle between the lines is 90 degrees. That is the condition. At most four normals. Let P be any point in the plane, its quadrates are say x1 comma y1. What is your target? At most four normals can be drawn through that point. Consider the equation of ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to 1. The equation of any normal to the ellipse is what? Ax by cos theta minus by sin theta is equals to a square minus b square. This is the equation of any normal to the ellipse. That means it is a p of theta, one of the feet of the normal. Understand? If this line passing through my point x1, y1, what happened? We obtain the condition that is ax1 by cos theta minus by1 by sin theta is equals to a square minus b square. This is the condition. Now, this is cos theta, this is sin theta. We have to write both in terms of single variable. That means, we have cos theta is equals to 1 minus tan square theta by 2 by 1 plus tan square theta by 2. Am I correct? Similarly, sin theta is equals to 2 tan theta by 2 by 1 plus tan square theta by 2. These are the two formulae. Like tan theta by 2 is equals to t, then this becomes 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square. This becomes 2t by 1 plus t square. Then we convert it into the single variable. Understand? So, this can be written as ax1 by, what is your cos theta? 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square.
1 minus t square by 1 plus t square minus by 1 by 2t by 1 plus t square is equals to a square minus b square. Now, it is nothing but 1 plus t square times of ax1 by 1 minus t square minus 1 plus t square times of by 1 by 2t is equals to a square minus b square. Now, by taking LCM, 1 plus t square times of 2t into ax1 minus 1 plus t square times of 1 minus t square into by1 is equals to a square minus b square times of 2t into 1 minus t square. That's all. So, this is nothing but 2t plus 2t cube times of ax1 minus of 1 minus t power 4 times of by1 is equals to a square minus b square times of 2t minus 2t cube. Is it equation in t or not? It is a fourth degree equation in t. So, it has four roots. Say t1, t2, t3, t4, where ti is equals to tan theta I by 2. Tan theta I by 2. I runs from 1 to 3, 4. So, how many parametric angles obtained? 4 parametric angles. These are the corresponding 4 feet of the normals. 4 feet of the normals. So, how many normals can you draw from that point to the ellipse at most? At most 4 normals can be drawn from given point to the ellipse. So, this is 4th degree equation T. When it is in 4th degree equation in T, we have 4 roots for that one. At most 4 real roots. Say T1, T2, T3, T4. What is your Ti? Tan theta I by 2. Where theta I is the eccentric angle of the corresponding foot of normal drawn from that point x1, y1 to the ellipse. So, at most 4 normals can be drawn from given point to the ellipse. So, you can simplify this one also. We have t power 4 is there, t cube term is there, t term is also there, constant is also there. So, we have t square term is missing here. Am I correct? Therefore, s2 becomes 0. And that means sum of the roots, product of the roots taken 2 at a time, product of the roots taken 3 at a time, product of the roots you may write from this 4th degree equation itself. So, anyhow, how many normals can you draw from that point? 4 normals can be drawn from the point to the ellipse. That means at most 4 normals can be drawn from the point to the ellipse. Okay. Next one. The sum of the eccentric angles of 4 co-normal points is odd multiple of pi. Sum of the eccentric angles of 4 co-normal points. How many normals can you draw from given point? At most 4 normals. Their sum of the eccentric angles, what you have to show? Odd multiple of pi. You are going to show that it is odd multiple of pi. This is your ellipse. Suppose it is any point. You can draw 4 normals through that point to the ellipse. These are 4 feet of normals. Their corresponding eccentric angles sum must be, how to show that it is odd multiple of pi, my dears. Okay, how to prove it? Well, same. We obtain 4th degree equation in the up to that proof is same. And then we are going to prove that the sum of the eccentric angles is odd multiple of pi. What is the equation of any normal to the ellipse? Ax by cos theta minus by by sin theta is equals to a square minus b square. If it is passing through the given point x1 comma y1, because this is the point where the four normals are drawn to the ellipse. If it is passing through x1, y1, ax1 by cos theta means what? 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square minus by 1 by 2t by 1 plus t square minus of a square minus b square is equals to 0. So 1 plus t square into 2t into ax1 minus 1 plus t square by1 into 1 minus t square into 1 minus t square, that is equals to or minus a square minus b square times of 1 minus t square into 2t. This is equals to 0. Now we write this equation in the fourth degree perfect form, that is something into t power 4 plus something into t cube plus something into t square plus something into t plus something into, that means some constant is equals to 0 we have tried. This is nothing but 2t plus 2t cube times of ax1 minus of 1 minus t power 4 times of by1 minus of a square minus b square into 2t minus 2t cube is equals to 0. Now 2t ax1 plus 2ax1 t cube minus by1 minus into minus plus by1 t power 4 minus a square 2t, 2a square t minus 2a square t minus into minus plus 2a square t cube. Next what? Minus into minus plus 2b square t minus into minus plus into minus minus 2b square t cube is equals to 0. So where is t power 4? This is t power 4 coefficient. By1 times of t power 4. Where is x, t cube coefficient? 2ax1 into t cube is there. Here is also 2a square t cube. Here is also minus 2b square t cube. So plus 2ax1 plus 2a square minus 2b square times of t cube is there. Is there any t square term? There is no t square term. Plus, you have tried the coefficient of t. What is the coefficient of t here? 2ax1. This is 2ax1. Next what? Where is t? Minus 2a square. This is minus 2a square. And next what? This is coefficient of minus 2a square. Plus 2b square is there. Plus 2b square. And what about the constant here? Minus by1. To ax1 minus 2a square minus 2b square, this is 2ax1. 2ax1 into t is there. 2ax1. Okay. This is the equation. By1 t power 4 plus 2ax1 plus 2a square minus 2b square into t cube. 2ax1 minus 2a square plus 2b square into t minus by1 is equals to 0. This is the fourth degree equation. Now we have to show that the sum of the four eccentric angles is odd multiple of pi. Suppose what is your ti? Ti is nothing but theta I by 2, because ti is equals to tan theta I by 2. Say the eccentric angles are theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4. Now tan of, now I am considering tan of theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4 by 4 is what? By 2 I am considering. Theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 3 by 4 is nothing but what? This is nothing but S1 minus S3 by 1 minus S2 plus S4. 1 minus S2 plus S4. This is S1 minus S3 by 1 minus S2 plus S4. Now clearly minus S3 is there, S4 is there. The, what is the S2 value? S2 value is nothing but 2ax1 plus 2a square minus 2b square by b by 1. This is s1. S1 means the sum of the roots. S2 means 0. Here there is no t square term. Therefore that is s2 is 0. S4 is what? Minus b by 1 by b by 1. That is minus 1. So what about denominator, my dears? 1 minus s2 plus s4. 1 minus s2 plus s4, that is equals to 1 minus s2 is 0, s4 is what? Plus minus b by 1 by b by 1, minus b by 1 by b by 1, that is cancelled, minus 1, that is 1 minus 1, 0. That means 1 by 0 is nothing but infinity. That means tan of theta 1 by 2 plus theta 2 by 2 plus theta 3 by 3 plus theta 4 by 2 is equals to infinity. We mean that angle must and should be odd multiple of pi by 2. Am I correct or not? Therefore, we have theta 1 by 2 plus theta 2 by 2 plus theta 3 by 2 plus theta 4 by 2 is equals to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. Now, cancelling 2 on both sides, we get sum of the eccentric angles is what? Theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4 is equals to 2n plus 1 into pi. That is sigma of theta I runs from 1 to 4, that is equals to 2n plus 1 into pi. Is it odd multiple of pi or not? Yes, it is odd multiple of pi. Therefore, we have S2. S2 is nothing but product of the roots taken 2 at a time. S4 is what? Product of the roots taken at a time. Product of the roots, all the roots, there are 4 roots, that is S4. 1 minus S2 plus S4 is 0. And moreover, from this equation, S1 is equals to S3. You calculate that. What is S1, my dears? Minus of 2ax1, 2a square, minus 2b square by b by 1. That is S1. What about S3? S3 is also 2ax1 minus 2a square plus 2b square by b by 1. Here, S1 is equals to S3. 2ax1, this is b by 1 square, t power 4, 2ax1 plus 2a square minus 2b square. See here, t cube coefficient once again, 2 cube, 2 into ax1 into t cube, 2ax1 t cube is there. Here also, t cube is there, 2a square t cube minus 2a square t cube is there. This is minus into minus plus, plus 2a square t cube is there. Again, you have for b square, that is minus b square into 2t. That means minus of minus plus 2b square into 2t is there. So, in this manner, we have the coefficients by1 t power 4, something into t cube plus something into t minus by1 is equals to 0. So, we have the equation in this manner. S2 is 0, S4 is minus 1. 1 minus 0 minus 1, that is nothing but 0. Therefore, sum of the eccentric angles is odd multiple of pi. Understand? Now, let us go for the another problem. So, 4 feet of normals are there. They are corresponding 4 eccentric angles. The sum is what, my dears? 0 here. Understand? This is the another condition. The sum of the eccentric angles of 4 concyclic points of an ellipse is even multiple of pi. What is the previous statement? Sum of the eccentric angles of 4 conormal points is always odd multiple of pi. Here even multiple of pi. What are these? These are the eccentric angles of the 4 concyclic points. There are conormal points, here are the 4 concyclic points. That means what? If you take any 4 points on the ellipse, if they lie on a circle also, we say that the 4 points are concyclic points. Understand? So, 4 conormal points are what? If you draw 4 normals from that point to the ellipse, you get 4 feet of normals. These 4 are called conormal points. Conormal points, sum of eccentric angles is odd multiple of pi, and sum of the eccentric angles of 4 concyclic points on our ellipse is what? Even multiple of pi, we are going to show that here. Understand? We mean, this is the ellipse. Suppose some circle intersects your ellipse at 4 points, say PQR, and S. These four points are concyclic now. These four points are concyclic now. Suppose these four points lies on your circle, x square plus y square is equal to r square. For some sake of convenience, you may take s equal to 0 also. Now, what is your equation of ellipse? X square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. If you want to take s is equal to 0, you may take, no problem. So, this is a circle x square plus y square equal to r square. This is ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Now, what is any point on your circle? If you take some point, a cos theta comma b sin theta is a point on the ellipse, that must and should be satisfies your circle equation. Any point, parametric point on ellipse is what? A cos theta comma b sin theta. This is the point on the ellipse as well as your circle also. Now, substitute the point here itself, we get a square cos square theta plus b square sin square theta is equals to r square. What is your cos square theta? A square into 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square. That is cos theta is equal to 1 minus tan square theta by 2 by 1 plus tan square theta by 2 whole square, you may write, plus b square into sin theta means 2t by 1 plus t square whole square is equals to r square. Now, is it fourth degree equation in t or not? Again, it is fourth degree equation in t. A square into 1 minus t square whole square plus b square into 4t square is equal to r square times of 1 plus t square whole square. R square times of 1 plus t square whole square. So, a square into 1 plus t power 4 minus 2t square plus b square into 4b square into t square is equal to r square times of 1 plus t power 4 plus 2t square. Clearly, it is also fourth degree equation in T. Now, my dears, what is the T power fourth coefficient here? A T power 4, A square T power 4, and what about T cube? There is no T cube, I think. So, here, A square, now, this is minus 2A square T square plus 4B square T square is also there. Now, minus 2r square t square. Next, what you have? R square t power 4. That means minus r square. A square minus r square into t power 4 is there. This is t square. What about your constant? There is no t term also. Understand? The constant is plus a square minus r square. This is a square minus r square times of t power 4, that is a square minus r square. This is t square. And there is no t term, there is no t cube term, is equal to 0 here. Now, what about tan of theta 1 by 2 plus theta 2 by 2 plus theta 3 by 2 plus theta 4 by 2, my dears? S1 minus S3 by 1 minus S2 plus S4. 1 minus S2 plus S4. This is tan of sigma theta I by 2. S1, there is no T cube term, that is 0. 0. S3, there is no T cube term, that is also 0. 0 minus 0 by something is there. That is 0. That means tan theta is equals to 0. That is for n pi. Am I correct or not? Theta 1 sigma theta I by 2 is equals to n pi. Therefore, sigma theta I is equals to 2 n pi. Am I correct or not? Therefore, sum of the four eccentric angles of concyclic points on ellipse is what? 2 n pi. So, it is also a simple derivation for you. But you have to write in the calculation part very clearly. Then you can easily conclude that one. So suppose your four points are conormal points, their sum of eccentric angles is odd multiple of pi. Here the four points are concentric points, then sum of the eccentric angles is even multiple of pi. This is 2n pi, that is 2n plus 1 times of pi. So this is the another property for you. Okay, and then go for next property. P is any point on the ellipse with foci at S and S dash. What are S and S dash? Foci of the ellipse. Then the tangent and normal are external and internal angular bisectors of S dash PS. So S and S dash are what? Foci of the ellipse. Normal, tangent are angular bisectors of the angle SP S dash. How to prove this one? Very important result for you. This is ellipse. P is any point on the ellipse. Their foci are S dash and this is S. This is now our angle. P, that is S dash PS is there. This is the tangent. It is external angular bisector. Then the tangent is external angular bisector. Understand? And the normal is what? Internal angular bisector. Normal at P. This is your internal angular bisector. This is the thing you have to prove. So, what is tangent here? The tangent at P is like this. This is the tangent. This is the normal. We are going to prove that these two are angular bisectors. The angle between the angular bisectors of pair of lines is always 90 degrees. Clearly, the tangent and the normal make angle 90 degrees. How to prove this one? This is your SP. This is SP, S dash P. Now, suppose this is the point Q, say, where the normal intersects the axis, major axis at Q. Suppose this is the point of intersection R, say. Now, all of you know that what is SP? Focal distance of point, SP. Suppose your point is say x1 comma y1, then focal distance is A minus EX1, this SP, this is the corresponding directrix, SP is equal to E into PM, that is A minus EX1. A minus EX1. If you take in the parametric form, you may write that one as A minus E into A cos theta. That is A into 1 minus E cos theta. If it is P of theta, say, your distance SP is equal to A into 1 minus E cos theta. Similarly, what about S dash P? S dash P is equal to A into 1 plus E cos theta. A into 1 plus E cos theta. Now, what is the ratio SP by S dash P? Is equals to 1 minus E cos theta by 1 plus E cos theta. This is SP by S dash P. It is, if it is equivalent to SQ by S dash Q, then your job is over. Normal is the internal angular bisector. Similarly, the tangent is also external angular bisector. So, when you are saying this is internal angular bisector, SP by S dash P is equals to SQ by S dash Q, then your job is over. So, how to obtain this Q? By solving x-axis with normal at P of theta. What is the equation of normal at P of theta? That is Ax by cos theta minus By by sin theta is equals to A square minus B square. This is the equation of normal at P of theta. Solve with x-axis. What is the equation of x-axis? Y equal to 0. Put y equal to 0 here, we get x is equals to A square minus B square into cos theta by A. This is x. So what are the coordinates of Q? Q is equals to A square minus B square into cos theta by a comma 0. These are the coordinates of Q. Now what about SQ? What is S? AE comma 0. What is S dash? Minus AE comma 0. So SQ is equals to the distance. SQ is equal to AE minus this one. AE minus A square minus B square into cos theta by A. This is nothing but A square E minus A square minus B square into cos theta whole divided by A. What is your B square value? A square minus B square is nothing but A square E square. All of you know that. That is A square E minus A square E square cos theta by A. You may cancel out A. You may take AE common. That is AE into 1 minus E cos theta. So SQ is equals to AE into 1 minus E cos theta. Similarly, we can prove that S dash Q is equals to AE into 1 plus E cos theta. S dash Q is equals to AE into 1 plus E cos theta. Understand? Now, AE into 1 minus E cos theta. Therefore, SQ by SQ dash. Now, SQ by SQ dash is nothing but AE into 1 plus E cos theta by, this is 1 minus E cos theta. 1 minus E cos theta by AE into 1 plus E cos theta. AE gets cancelled. So the ratio is 1 minus E cos theta by 1 plus E cos theta. So both are same or not? SP by S dash P is equals to SQ by SQ dash. SQ by S dash Q. This is S dash Q. SQ by S dash Q. Therefore, SP by S dash P is equals to SQ by S dash Q. Hence, what we conclude? This is the internal angular bisector. Similarly, write the tangent at P, you get the coordinates of R, and then show that that is nothing but SP by S dash Q is equals to SR by S dash R. SR by S dash R. Hence, this tangent is also external angular bisector. So, we conclude that this is the angle. What is your angle? S dash PS. Then, the normal is what? Internal angular bisector. The tangent is what? External angular bisector. With the help of this property, if any ray passing through this focus meets the circumference of the ellipse, then its reflected ray automatically passing through another focus. Your reflected ray automatically passing through another focus. This is the very, very important property, reflection property. By using the tangent and normal or external and internal angular bisectors to this angle S dash PS. Understand? Suppose this ray travels in this manner, and if it meets the parabola and it meets the ellipse at this point, and this reflected ray automatically passing through this focus, and then it meets the ellipse at this point again, that is passing through the another focus. So in this manner we can do all this practice. So, if any ray passing through focus and meets the ellipse at the point P, then the reflected ray always passing through the another focus. And if it is passing through this point, it meets the ellipse again at this point, and then reflected ray passing through the first focus. That is S dash. So, in this manner, we can run the ray, reflected ray property. Understood? So, finally, any ray passing through one focus meets the ellipse, then its reflected ray passing through the another focus. What is the reflected property on your parabola? If any ray passing through in this manner, that is parallel to axis, meets the parabola at some point, then the reflected ray passing through your focus. Your reflected ray passing through your focus. Understand? That means if any ray passing through focus meets the parabola, then its reflected ray passing through the line which is parallel to the axis. In this manner also you can write. Okay, these are the reflection properties with respect to the parabola. This is with respect to ellipse. Understand? Now let us move for the next. So these are the problems. So after we discuss the properties, like the exactly four, that means at most four normals can be drawn from given point to the ellipse, and there are 4 feet of normals. Sum of the eccentric angles of the 4 feet of normals is always odd multiple of pi, and sum of the 4 concentric points on ellipse is even multiple of pi. They are eccentric angles. Sum of the eccentric angles of 4 concentric points on ellipse is even multiple of pi, and the tangent and normal at any point are the external and internal angular bisectors of angle S dash PS, where P is a point on the ellipse. Okay, now let us do the problems. Find the coordinates of point on the ellipse x square plus 3y square equal to 37, at which the normal is parallel to the line 6x minus 5y is equals to 2. 6x minus 5y is equals to 2. Find the coordinates of point on the ellipse x square plus 3y square is equals to 37, at which the normal is parallel to the line 6x minus 5y is equals to 2. So what you have to find out? You are going to find out the coordinates of point on that ellipse at which the normal is parallel to your line 6x minus 5y equal to 2. So this is your ellipse, given ellipse x square plus 3y square equal to 37. This is the line, given line. What is that line? 6x minus 5y equal to 2. We are going to find the coordinates of the point on the ellipse at which the normal is parallel to that line. This is the line, this is normal line which is parallel to your given line. So at that tangent, this is perpendicular. We have to find out the points on the ellipse at which the normal is parallel to our line. So what is the equation of ellipse? X square plus 3y square is equals to 37. Understand? To get the slope of tangent, what you have to do? Differentiate. Differentiate with respect to x, what you have? 2x plus 6y y dash is equals to 0. So what about y dash? Minus 2x by 6y. That is 3 times. Minus x by 3y. This is the slope of tangent at any point. Slope of normal. Slope of normal is equals to plus 3y by x. Product of slopes is equals to minus 1. Now I am going to equate this to minus 6 by minus 5. That is 6 by 5. Because lines are parallel, their slopes are equal. So I am taking the slope 3y by x to 6 by 5. This is the normal at any point on the ellipse. If that normal is parallel to my given lines, that is 6x minus 5y equal to 2, we have to equate their slopes. So 3 2s. What about y by x? 2 by 5 implies y is equal to 2 by 5x. Substitute this y equal to 2 by 5x in your ellipse, we obtain the required points. So x square plus, what about y square? 3 times of y square is there. 4 by 25x square is equals to 37. So 25x square plus 12x square, 37x square by 25 is equals to 37. 37, 37 gets cancelled. X square is equals to 25. Therefore, x is equal to plus or minus 5. When x equal to plus or minus 5, y is what? 2 by 5 times of plus or minus 5. 5, 5 gets cancelled. That is plus or minus 2. Therefore, the points on the ellipse are what? 5 comma 2 is one point and minus 5 comma minus 2 is the another point at which the normals to the ellipse are parallel to my line, that is 6x minus 5y is equals to 2. 6x minus 5y is equals to 2. Okay, very simple problem. It is just tracked by equating the slopes of the normals to the given line. This is the normal to the ellipse. This is the given line. Okay. Next one. The normal at one end of the lattice rectum of the ellipse, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, passing through one end of the minor axis, then we have to show that e power 4 plus e square is equals to 1. What is the given thing? The normal at one end of the lattice rectum of ellipse. Normal at one end of the lattice rectum of ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. That is passing through one end of minor axis. Then you are going to show that e power 4 plus e square is equals to 1. So, what is the experiment here? We are going to draw the normal at end of the lattice rectum. If they are passing through one end of the minor axis, this is the result you are going to prove. So consider the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to 1. This is the ellipse. And this is the axis, major axis, minor axis. This is the point on the ellipse, that is end of the lattice rectum. At that point we are going to draw the normal, that is the corresponding tangent at that point. This is the normal. The normal is drawn at this point. That normal passing through what? End of the minor axis. At that time we are going to show that e power 4 plus e square is equals to 1. Very, very important result for you. What are the coordinates of ends of lattice rectum here? This is the lattice rectum. This is positive end of the lattice rectum I am taking here. That is what? AE comma B square by A. So, all of you know that what is the equation of normal at x1, y1? A square x by x1 minus b square y by y1 is equals to a square minus b square. Your point x1 comma y1 is what? AE comma b square by A. So, replace x1 by AE and y1 by b square by A. So, we have normal at end of lattice rectum. Normal at end of lattice rectum is what? A square x by x1 means AE minus b square y by y1 means b square by A is equals to a square minus b square. B square, b square cancel, a cancel out a times. So we have ax by e minus ay is equals to a square minus b square. This is the normal passing through what? One end of the minor axis. What are the coordinates of this minor end? 0 comma minus b. Substitute 0 comma minus b. We get this is 0 minus into minus plus ab is equal to a square minus b square. From here itself we can easily derive that one as e power 4 plus e square is equals to 1. Am I clear or not? Dividing on both sides by a square, what happened? A square minus b square by a square is equals to ab by a square, that is b by a. What about this? E square. E square is equals to b by a. Again squaring, e power 4 is equals to b square by a square. So, b square by a square means what? 1 minus e square. Therefore, immediately we obtain the condition e power 4 plus e square is equals to 1. So your answer is what? E power 4 plus E square equal to 1. Very, very important result for you. Normal at end of lattice rectum, passing through one end of minor axis, then E power 4 plus E square is equals to 1. Next one. This is the problem. Read yourself. What is that? The tangent and a normal to the ellipse, x square plus 4y square is equal to 4. X square plus 4y square equal to 4. At a point, P of theta on it meets the major axis in Q and R respectively. If 0 less than theta less than pi by 2 and QR is equals to 2, then we have to show that theta is equals to cos inverse of 2 by 3. Cos inverse of 2 by 3, you are going to prove that. The tangent and normal to the ellipse at point P of theta meets the major axis at Q and R respectively. If 0 less than theta less than pi by 2 and QR is equals to what? 2 units. Then we have to show that the eccentric angle of the corresponding point is cos inverse 2 by 3. So let us try to draw the figure. This is your ellipse. X square plus 4y square equal to 4. We mean x square by 4 plus y square by 1 equal to 1, a greater than b case. This is the axis. This is the point, any point whose eccentric angle is theta, say. Draw the tangent. That tangent intersects the axis at that point. This is the point, and it is the normal at that point. It intersects the major axis at this point. And given that the distance from here to here is 2 units. Now we are going to find out the eccentric angle of that point P. This is your Q. This is your R. So QR is equals to 2 units. How to get the coordinates of Q and R? By solving the x-axis with the tangent and normal. What is the equation of tangent at P of theta? Tangent at P of theta is x by a cos theta. A square is 4, a is 2. X by 2 cos theta plus y by b sin theta is equals to 1. It needs x-axis. So put y equal to 0. Put y equal to 0, what happened? X is equals to 2 by cos theta. Therefore, the coordinates of Q is equals to 2 by cos theta comma 0. These are the coordinates of Q. Similarly, can you find the equation of normal at P of theta or not? Yes. Equation of normal at P of theta is what? Ax by cos theta. A means 2. 2x by cos theta minus by 1 into y. Y by sin theta is equals to a square minus b square. 4 minus 1, that is 3. Now, we solve this normal with x-axis. What is equation of x-axis? Y equal to 0. Put y equal to 0 here also. Put y equal to 0. What happened? X is equals to 3 cos theta by 2. Therefore, the coordinates of R is 3 cos theta by 2 comma 0. So, this is Q. This is R. Can you find QR distance or not? Therefore, this is QR is equals to, what is the x coordinate of Q? 2 by cos theta. That is right side. This is farthest from the origin. Therefore, we may take the difference as 2 by cos theta minus 3 cos theta by 2. 2 by cos theta minus 3 cos theta by 2. Its distance is 2 units they are given to you. Now, the question becomes solving of the what? The trigonometric equation. Therefore, 2 2's are 4 minus 3 cos square theta is equals to 4 cos theta. This is 4 cos theta. Implies 3 cos square theta plus 4 cos theta minus 4 equal to 0. 4 3's are 12, 6 2's are also 12. So, we are finding the factors. 3 cos square theta plus 6 cos theta minus 2 cos theta minus 4 equal to 0. Therefore, 3 cos theta into cos theta plus 2 minus 2 into cos theta plus 2 equal to 0. Cos theta plus 2 never 0. Therefore, 3 cos theta equal to 2. We have 3 cos theta equal to 2. Cos theta is equals to 2 by 3 implies theta is equals to cos inverse of 2 by 3. Therefore, the isentric angle of the corresponding point is what, my dears? Cos inverse of 2 by 3. It is very simple for you. Just by solving the tangent with x-axis and solving the normal with x-axis, you get 2 points. Equate the distance from the Q to arc as 2 units. Then immediately we obtain a trigonometric equation. On solving this trigonometric equation, we obtain theta as cos inverse 2 by 3. Okay? Thank you.